Good morning, Lakeshore families. We're so happy you're here with us today.
Hello and good morning, everyone.
Good morning, Selah Park. Hi, guys at Lakeshore.
Good morning, Selah Park. I hope you guys are doing well this morning. I hope you had an awesome week. We are pumped to be able to continue to bring you Selah Park here in your homes or wherever you may be today. But I hope you're doing well this morning. I hope you are awake and ready to worship and ready to dive into God's Word and learn more about Jesus today. But before we get started, you know, we've got to have our race. And so today, we are going to race something that I've driven before, but I doubt any of you have, maybe some toy ones. But anyway, let's check out what we're going to race. All right, so today we are racing tractors. And yes, I've driven an actual tractor before. I actually, for a period of time, worked on a farm when I lived in North Carolina. And so I actually drove one of those green John Deere tractors. But hey, which one of these tractors do you think is going to be the fastest today? Are you going to go with the blue tractor? Are you going to go with the green John Deere looking tractor? Or how about the red one? So take a few seconds, take a good look at them, and make your decision of which one you think is going to be the fastest tractor today. And let's count down. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go.
Who remembers our big picture question? That's right. It is Jesus God or a human? So pay attention to this week's lesson, and we're going to have the answer at the end.
Hey, guys. It's great. I love seeing all your videos worshiping. Now's the time we're going to do that. So make a joyful noise, and everybody stand up, and let's see those videos of you worshiping.
I want more, I want more. call you home. I don't know where you eat your meals or where you talk on the phone. I don't know if you got a cook, a butler, or a maid. I don't know if you got a yard with a hammock in the shade. I don't know if you got some shelter, say a place to hide. I don't know if you live with friends and who you can confide. I don't know if you got a family, say a mom or dad. I don't know if you love it all, but I bet you wish you had. Come and go with me to my father's house. Come and go with me to my father's house. It's a big, big house with lots and lots of room. A big, big table with lots and lots of food. House. Come and go with me to my father's house. It's a big, big house with lots and lots of room. A big, big table with lots and lots of food. A big, big yard where we can play football. A big, big house. It's my father's house. A big, big house with lots and lots of room. My father's house.
Okay, guys, it's time for us to do our communion time together. So at this time, we just want you to pause the video if you have not grabbed your elements. And if you already have them ready, great. So I'm going to say a prayer in just a minute. And when you feel ready, you take your elements, okay? And if you have not been baptized, that's okay. We want you to spend the next few minutes just thanking God for what he's done for us, thanking him for his son, and getting your head and your heart in the right space to be baptized soon. I'm going to pray for us, and then you guys take your elements, okay? Lord, we just thank you so much for another beautiful day, another wonderful day with you. We are so grateful for your son. We're so grateful that we get to celebrate together online. We are so ready to be back together, and we're going to do that soon, but we just want to be so grateful and thankful for all the things that we're able to do safely during this time, and we just ask that you be with us each this week, and it's in your son's name we pray, amen.
So last week, we talked about how the angel Gabriel appeared to Zechariah and told him that his wife, Elizabeth, in her very old age, was going to have a baby, a little baby boy, and we're going to name him John. And if you remember, John's whole purpose for being born was he was going to prepare the way for the coming Messiah. He was going to get people ready for Jesus, all right? And so after the angel appeared to Zechariah, he also, the angel Gabriel, went and appeared to Mary and told Mary that she was going to be a mom and that she was going to give birth to a baby boy. And this baby boy was going to be the Son of God. And she was to name him Jesus. And she was told that he was going to be great, that he was going to be called the Son of the Most High. All right? So we went from the angel telling Zechariah that his wife was going to have a baby boy that was going to prepare the way for Jesus, to now the angel telling Mary she is going to be pregnant with a little boy, and he is going to be Jesus, and he is going to be God's Son. Right, so let's watch this video and find out how this all took place.
Mary and Joseph lived in the town of Nazareth. During the time Mary was pregnant, the Roman Emperor Caesar Augustus announced that everyone needed to be registered for a census. Since Joseph was a descendant of King David, he and Mary traveled to Bethlehem, the city of David. While they were there, the time came for Mary to have her baby. Mary and Joseph looked for a safe place to stay, but every place was full. So Mary and Joseph found a place where animals were kept, and that is where Mary had her baby. Joseph named him Jesus. Mary wrapped the baby tightly in cloth and laid him in a feeding trough. That night, some shepherds were watching over their sheep in the fields near Bethlehem. Suddenly, an angel stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them. They were terrified. The angel said, "Don't be afraid. I have very good news for you and for all the people. Today, a Savior, who is the Messiah and the Lord, was born for you in the city of David." Then the angel said, "You will find a baby wrapped tightly in cloth and lying in a manger." Suddenly, a whole army of angels appeared, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven and peace on earth to people he favors." When the angels left and returned to heaven, the shepherds decided to go see if the angels' words were true. They hurried to Bethlehem and found Mary and Joseph and the baby, who was lying in the feeding trough. Then the shepherds went and told others about the baby Jesus. Everyone who heard about Jesus was surprised and amazed. Mary thought about everything that was happening and tried to understand it. The shepherds returned to their fields, praising God because everything had happened just as the angel said. The birth of Jesus was good news. Jesus was not an ordinary baby. He is God's Son, sent to earth from heaven. Jesus, the promised Savior, came into the world to deliver us from sin and death.
What an incredible story, and what an incredible journey. Can you imagine Mary and Joseph on their journey from Nazareth to Bethlehem? That wasn't a short little trip, guys. That was about 90 miles away. So that was a long journey for them. Cars hadn't been invented yet, so they had to walk or ride donkeys or whatever. But it was quite an adventure for them. And then to get there after that long journey and to try to find a place for Mary to have the baby, can you imagine knocking on every door and nothing is available? And finally, the only place that was available for Mary to have a baby was, you know, a place where animals were kept. And in a stable area, all right? And so here we have the King of all kings, the Son of God, being born amongst animals. It's a crazy, crazy story. But that is the reason why Jesus was born, okay, was to be the Savior, right? His name means Savior. And he wasn't born just to teach us to be good or show us the right things to do. He also was born to be that person to save us from sin and to save us from death. A Savior is somebody who comes and saves us from danger or destruction. And, you know, Jesus was born to rescue us from the sin that we have in our lives and to rescue us from an eternal death. So why was Jesus' birth good news? You know, we hear that term, you may have heard that term before, that the good news of Jesus. Well, listen, guys, we need to understand that Jesus came to this earth because we needed him. All right. God showed his love for us by sending us his son into the world. You know, we were separated from God because of our sin. All right. And during that separation, God had a plan. He was working on a plan to bring us back to him. All right. And God used Jesus as part of that plan. He was working out a promise to rescue us, to rescue all sinners through the life and the death and the resurrection of Jesus. And that's good news. So why do you think Jesus was born in such a humble way? Have you ever thought about that? I mean, he is going to be the King of all kings. He is the Son of God. So why was he born into some huge palace, you know, amongst royalty or a wealthy family? Now, why was he born amongst animals? Well, check this out. Think about this. Because of the way Jesus was born and because of his upbringing, Jesus can relate to ordinary people, all right? Yes, he was God, all right? He was royalty. He was the King of all kings, but the way he lived and the way that he was born, we can all relate to. Jesus was fully human, all right? He lived a life here on this earth just like we live, all right? He dealt with the things that we deal with. And so that helps us to be able to relate to him, all right? And he is so personable with us. God sent him down here to be among people, and he gave up, you know, his glory and all of his power to live humbly among us. All right, and his birth reflects how his kingdom's values, or shows us how his kingdom values really differ from the world's values. All right, and because of the way he was born, we can now boldly and humbly approach him and approach his throne. So why should we tell other people about Jesus? Why should we tell the good news? Listen, we need to understand that salvation through Jesus, it brings us a privilege, and it also brings us a responsibility of sharing the gospel, the salvation, with the world and with the people that we come across in our world. You know, God calls us to live as witnesses of Jesus and to witnesses of that saving power that Jesus gives us, and he wants us to live in a way and to share that news and be an example in the way that we say things and the way that we live our lives, okay? Just as we needed rescuing from our sins, there are people in this world, and there are people that you know that need to be rescued, that need Jesus. So my challenge to you this week is to look for those opportunities, all right? Look for ways to share the good news of Jesus, okay? Look for somebody that you know needs him, that's lost, somebody that doesn't have a relationship with Jesus, okay? And most of all, be Jesus by the way that you act and by the way that you speak, okay? Set that example, all right, through love. And show people Jesus through your example, all right? So guys, take this message that we often hear at Christmas. And remember, this isn't just a one-time message of Jesus' birth at Christmas time, but this is something that we need to remember every day, all right? The birth of Jesus is an amazing thing, all right? His birth changed the world forever, all right? and saved us. And so, guys, take this time. Take this week. Look in Luke, in the book of Luke, and read chapters 1 and 2. And learn more about what we've talked about here today. See it for yourself. Don't just listen to me. Take some time this week and look into the book of Luke, who was a doctor, you know, who wrote this book and wrote down this account of Jesus's birth.
Hey guys, so this week we are continuing on with our memory verse of John 3:16, and we know that it reads, "For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son, that whoever believes in him shall not die, but have everlasting life." And now we are so focused on this verse just because it shows exactly how much God truly loves us. It shows his never-ending love. It shows that he wants to be with you and he wants you to be with him forever till the very end. That's the everlasting part. Now, you guys have been doing an absolutely wonderful job each and every week remembering this, but let's keep on with this just so we can really, really get it. Anybody that's still kind of sort of maybe forgetting one or two words, like I do every once in a while, we can go ahead and practice it and do it together. Now, here we go. Let's practice, okay? You guys ready? All right. For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son, that whoever believes in him shall not die, but have everlasting life. Nice, y'all guys are doing wonderful. Now, don't forget, keep on practicing that. Just like I told you last week, find someone that you may have not said it to yet and go tell them, see if they know it maybe. Ask them if they know what John 3:16 is. Oh, they're like, I'm not 100% sure. Be like, I got this. And then you tell them, okay? Now, don't forget, it's John 3:16, guys.
So, the big picture question answer for today is Jesus God or human? And as the Son of God, Jesus is fully both human and fully God. He is the greatest gift we could ever receive. He came to earth to be our Savior and to be our King.
Thank you guys so much for being with us today. You guys are doing an absolutely positively fantastic job each and every week with us. Now, don't forget, like I've been telling you guys, you can all go online and print all of the activity lessons that we have there. That way you can do them at home, just like you would if we were together actually at church and in the classroom. Now, you guys take care and have a fantastic day, and we'll see you next week. Bye.
Bye, guys. It was great hanging with you today.
Hey, guys. Thank you so much for joining us today. We enjoy spending our time with you each Sunday. We have Father's Day coming up soon, so if you could go ahead and send some pictures of Dad and you either doing something fun or helping Dad or just Dad in his element, we'd love to do a little slideshow with Dad just like we did for Mother's Day. So send those in to us, and we'd be glad to do that for Father's Day so we can honor our fathers. We hope you have a great day. We'll see you soon. Bye.
Hey guys, thanks again for hanging out with us this morning. It really is a great time to be able to be with you every Sunday and still be a part of your lives. But hey, I want to encourage you to be back with us next Sunday. And as we continue to, now that Jesus is born, we can continue to walk through his life while he is here on this earth and learn everything we can about him. But I also wanted to make another quick reminder. We mentioned this last week, but if you didn't get a chance to hear this, but I just want to remind you about camp. Our week of camp that was originally scheduled for the first week in June is actually, you know, not going to happen. We were actually supposed to be leaving today. But anyway, it has been moved to the end of July, July 26th through the 31st at White Mills Christian Camp. And so if you plan on going to that camp, I suggest that you get on the White Mills Christian Camp website, and you can go ahead and register. You don't have to pay anything right now, no down payments or anything, but go ahead and get your spot reserved. Just want to let you know that as of now, it's still on, and we are still planning that week. But I want you to get you plugged in and ready to go, and hopefully we'll be able to carry that week out. But anyway, guys, have an awesome week, and look forward to seeing you, and take care, and be Jesus to anybody that you can.
This is me and my dog, and this is Kelly and Moose. And also,
Second is Turtley. He's right here, and that is Moose, way over there.
Yeah.
So, he really likes, we made him a little home over there, so he really likes him in there.
The Moose really likes the
you
tree.
For God so loved the world, he gave his one and only Son, that whoever believes him should not die, but have everlasting life.
And where is that found?
John 3:16.